So we're here at Prismic with Guillermo, CEO of Zed, and we had other interviews about serverless, but I wanted to focus one video on Next, which is pretty neat technology, especially like with React and all what's happening around React. I guess Next did some good decisions right there.
Yeah, so serverless works for any framework or technology, any programming language pretty much. But we are big fans of React and JavaScript and TypeScript at our company. So we wanted to have a developer experience and a scalable model for writing React applications. And that's how Next got started. Next is simply a wrapper around React that gives you an actual model for developing applications.
It's a universal app.
Yeah, so Next.js has this property that it can server render, or it can statically export any of the entry points or pages of your application.
Right. So that means what? Like if I have a page full of components, you will go rendering all the components.
Yeah, so typically the way that people have been doing React is they do a monolith. So they create an app.js script and they put all the chips in one place. They put all their eggs in one basket. And it's not really scalable model in any sense, because your code sort of grows infinitely in size, your bundles get huge. Yeah.
And you broke it down into pages.
Yeah. So Next.js tells you, hey, you know, instead of doing one big bundle for your entire application, you create a pages directory. And then each of the pages that you put in there then become the entry points of your app. So like if you create pages, settings.js for the settings panel of your app, then you can go to mywebsite.com/settings and it will only render that page, which means you only get the JS and CSS and component tree for that one page.
Right, and what about the requests? If you're requesting data for imagine I have a page, the home page, and I want to request a lot of data. How do you handle that with the rendering when you render server side?
Yeah, so when Next runs in server rendering mode, what we do is we get the data from wherever source you want. So this could be, you know, querying an API or using GraphQL, or you know, you could even query a database. Then once the data is obtained, we just pass it on to React. So the nice thing about Next is that it's pretty much just React. Just like React says they're just JavaScript, we're just React.
Well, you're more opinionated. So React, the React community or React maintainers, they've been like trying their best not to take opinions, not to decide.
Yeah, I would say it's not really opinionated, because this is how the web always worked. You know, you had distinct pages that you go to. That's what we call the directory pages.
So you're getting back to that model of pages.
Exactly.
So
like we're getting back to the roots. I think they were opinionated and we're not opinionated. But
you can say it that way.
I do think that some opinions are very, very important. I think some conventions are very important. I think it's a matter of taste. It's about striking a balance between let's not have developers repeat the same actions every single time they start a new app, with also letting them use the patterns that the React ecosystem has developed.
Right.
Because you don't want to like split the ecosystem into Next and React. So that's where the opinions end. Once you write the code for your page, that's all React. That's why some people call Next more of a compiler than a framework.
But it's what I liked about it is that it's maybe the toughest thing when you start with React is to know how to organize your code exactly. There are some practices and patterns.
Yes.
But you're very clear about these patterns so that you don't spend a lot of time thinking about this.
Yeah,
but you go right
I think
at the point.
I've seen that countless times where code organization, how do I organize my code? Another pattern that we've seen is people that need to design frameworks for their companies need to invent all these patterns from scratch. And then everyone at the company sort of inherits this pattern. So the barrier to entry is pretty high.
Yeah.
Whereas when we talk to really big users of Next.js, like really, really, really large projects, what they typically give us as feedback is like, I love that I can just open a project and navigate through it, I understand everything that's going on.
Because you understand the structure.
Right.
So I guess in next video, we can talk about Next and Gatsby, which is another framework that is
very hot discussion.
Yeah, let's do that.